Tony, just a little intro. This is on, so observe what is. This is on South Africa then and now. It's Tony Sims, am I correct? Just Tony, just give me briefly your age, your married, occupation, and a little bit about yourself. Just brief.
Okay, my name is Tony. I'm 52 years old. I've been married for 12 years now. I live in Durban, and I work in IT for a global company as a systems analyst.
Wonderful. All right, we need to talk about apartheid, the first period. What was it like during the apartheid era for you?
Well, I guess growing up in apartheid was the only way we knew. Once I was particularly prejudiced against black people, but we had black servants, but we always treated them with respect. And I guess we were just accustomed going to places where there were whites only, like the beaches and the movies and that kind of thing, and restaurants.
What were your parents' view at the time on this? Your parents? How did they bring you up for this? What were their views on that?
Well, I don't know that they hold any particularly strong views. They just accepted the situation, but they just taught me that we just respected black people, but they just didn't enjoy the same privileges that we did.
The schools, jobs, work. What did they teach you at school? Did they teach you apartheid at school? That this was how we should live our lives with apartheid? Was it taught at
No,
school?
we weren't taught anything about it. It was,
Okay.
just the way it was. We just went to school where there were whites only, and we just lived it. We weren't particularly taught about it.
Did you feel it was right at the time? I'm not talking about now. Now you might have changed your views, but at the time, I mean, was it right?
Probably not, but I guess I didn't question it. I just accepted the status quo, and I couldn't really imagine things differently. I remember when things did start opening up, and I remember one time thinking that maybe I wouldn't be able to go to movies anymore because there'd be black people, but I guess that's just the mindset that I had at the time.
And at that time, how did you treat people of other races at the time? Of your parents, how did the whites in general treat the races of the of people of other color at that time period?
No, I always treated them with respect. I think of my mother, and I remember the maid arriving one day, and my mother said, "Flora, just relax a while, watch a bit of TV." So that was my mother. And my father at work, he always got on, well with the black people, and they respected him. They had a nickname for him, and he was always helping them with their financial situations, and
Your mom is
looking
a
after them.
liberal person.
Now, I wouldn't say she's liberal. She was just a caring person. She wasn't really
Political or liberal.
not politically liberal, no.
Did you mix with people of other race groups? It must have been difficult to mix with them because I mean we had all these laws and stuff. I mean, did you ever mix with them
Well,
socially? I know maybe at work.
I think back to my school days, and I remember once, for a time we had a number of black gardeners, but I remember the one in particular, and a very nice guy, and my mother kind of encouraged him, and what she did was, I don't know how it came, I remember how it came about. Myself and my friend, we used to go running. So the gardener would go running with us, and my mother got him all registered a running club, and we she actually got him registered to run in the Comrades. But in a build-up, we'd take him on training runs, we'd second him and that, and so my mother got him running the Comrades. But myself and my white friend, we kind of befriended the guy, so we did. He was one of my black friends at the time when I was at high school.
Oh, wonderful. Good. Did you fight in the war? Were you in the army?
I was in the Navy, so I never got to see combat as such, but I did my 2 years in the Navy.
Did you agree with that? I mean, I know there were white South Africans didn't go to the war because of conscientious agreements. Did you know about that?
Yeah, I was aware of it. I must say I didn't question it. I just it was just what we did. We went to defend our country. Just on that point, being in the Navy was a bit different. I spent some time down in Cape and in Simonstown. And actually, even in Simonstown, there was a large Indian contingent. And the one naval base that I was at there for a time, I was the only white resident on the base with about 120 Indians, so. So I got to learn, to integrate with Indians, particularly during that time.
I'm not sure if I asked you, was it right at that time, in your opinion, or was it wrong?
I don't think I actually questioned it. It just seemed like our country was under attack, so I was doing it more for my
But
country
if you
rather
look
than
back
protect.
now, if you look back, was it right? What we,
Well.
the apartheid government, were they right with what they did?
Well,
Obviously, we most people will say, but I'm wanting to know if some people think it was right.
yeah, looking back, I kind of find it a bit unbelievable what we accepted at the time, and in hindsight, it was definitely wrong, but that definitely wasn't my mindset at the time.
Yeah, exactly what you've actually said is quite a thing there, because actually at the time we felt it was right.
Yes.
Yes, yeah, we felt it was right. It was right at the time to us, in
Well,
our in the way we felt about it. Yeah.
it felt okay,
Yeah, I think I mean, obviously, I mean, if we think back, we, I mean, you know, it's obviously, I mean, I suppose that's, I don't want to add my opinions, but yes, at the time you probably felt it was right because you knew nothing better. You're
Yeah.
nothing really better. Anyway, it's were you happy about the transition to the new government?
I was.
You were happy when they the new South Africa was went democratic with Nelson Mandela.
The early years, I guess, I probably had my doubts, and I was actually in the Navy in Cape Town at the time that Nelson Mandela was on Robben Island, and I actually went on to Robben Island while he was there. I didn't get to see him, but you just portrayed, as a very negative image. But I just remember, like in the time leading up to the transition, I remember Tokyo 6 while in particular being interviewed on TV, and just the way he came across, I think he kind of swayed me, and I saw that there was, hope in the situation. And particularly once Mandela was released, I think you just I guess kind of poured like oil on the waters to calm things, and so the transition was fine for me.
On this period, do you think a lot of the reason why the apartheid was in power or came into being, or the reasons for it, would be fear on our part? We were afraid of them, afraid of people of other race groups. Say that, no.
Partly fear, but I think supremacy, and if you look over the history of our country, before we had a black government, the Afrikaners were ruling, but before them, it was the British. So I think whoever was in control at the time, pushed down the others. So, for example, when you had an Afrikaans government, it wasn't just the black people that were pushing down. It was, they were pushing down the English as well.
Yeah, I heard a lot about that. In fact, there was a bit of discrimination within the whites, especially towards English people.
Yeah.
I mean, we were like in Natal, like we were the last colonial outpost And we and whites weren't accepted within the Afrikaans culture.
But I mean, before that, the British did the same thing. Now, when the British came past South Africa, before that, there was this whole process of Anglicisation, and so that they pushed down the
Afrikaans people.
the Afrikaans people before them. So,
Right, brilliant. Thank you, Tony. Anything else on this period before the transition that you'd like to add?
The period before the transition,
Before the, the old apartheid when we still have anything else you want to add on that?
but I can't
Not
think of
today.
anything
All
now.
right, we're going to talk about the second period. This is today.
All right.
How's it for South Africa? How's it in South Africa for you now? Is it better or is it worse?
Probably in some ways better, and it's not the lifting of apartheid. I think what's got worse is just bad government,
Explain.
just all the corruption and I just think of the hope that we had, the Rainbow Nation that that had this hope when Nelson Mandela first came into power, and we've kind of lost it.
You know, I want to ask you, sorry to interrupt you, but I want to ask you, don't we? I mean, we as white people now talk about the corruption in government. Wasn't the Afrikaans government very corrupt with the Boer Bond and and with the idea of, I'm just asking this, but the idea of sheltered employment, also the railways, wasn't that part of the Afrikaans? I'm asking that question.
No,
And in some ways
absolutely.
they were corrupt.
No, sure. I mean,
Or we were.
corruption just goes as government in any country, and there's countries in Europe which are even worse than our government, and the Afrikaans government was no better. There undoubtedly was corruption. I think they're a bit more subtle about it. And I don't know that it was as widespread, but I just think, particularly our current situation, I think it's particularly bad, and we've got people really enriching themselves at the expense of others, and it's at the expense of the people that got them into power.
I'm going to ask you a question now. Is everybody right in the context of the world that they believe in? Just listen to why I'm asking it. What I'm saying is, let's take for example, we can get extreme with it. Say you believe you're a Christian, you believe in Jesus Christ and God, and you've got a Muslim person that believes in God, and you've got a Hindu person that believes in their gods. Now, in their world and what they believe in, they're right. And you've got somebody that steals from you, steals food from you, he's a thief. And he does that because you don't give him any food and he's hungry. Is he right in the context of the world that he lives in, that he believes in? Is everybody right in their own context of the world? I know it's a difficult question.
Well, I guess when it comes to your religious beliefs, everyone's possibly is right. Everyone's entitled to their own beliefs, and I'm entitled to mine, and I'm convinced that mine's right. I'm not so sure about theft. I don't really condone that, but I guess there are situations where people are desperate and they have to resort to that, but I don't believe it makes it right.
You know why I'm bringing it up, and it fits with South Africa, it can fit with other subjects as well, because a lot of the time, for example, in the past, for example, the whites were privileged and they felt in the context of the world that they were right about what they were doing. And a lot of the non-race, the other race groups today feel that it's our time now. We need to get all the jobs, and we complain about them, being in government, it's welfare, but they believe that they are now right to their fair share of what they didn't get when they were oppressed in the apartheid area. I mean, how do you feel about that? That's really what I was trying to aim at.
That's a difficult one, I don't actually agree with that.
No
I think
problem.
there
Tell me
should
why.
be
Yes.
equal opportunity, and that's what our government today, in particular, was meant to be about. New hope for the country, and I think that should go first. I suppose you have to level the playing field to an extent, but at the end of the day, there should be natural processes that come to play, and people should have equal opportunity. So,
Well, for example, the affirmative action is one way of redressing the past. And are we
yeah.
in agreement with, how do you feel about that? BEE and affirmative action, is this the right thing to do?
No, I don't think it is.
Explain.
I think it's been abused. Let me put it that way. And I think perhaps there is a place for it. And it was kind of interesting. I went to, I paid a visit to LRV Village, up near Verulam or wherever. And basically, they've got these orphans and that, and they bring them up, they school them and everything. And they've set up a model, and it's all built on BEE. And part of the reason I went there was with our company, because our company supports them, so we get BEE points. That's a perfect example of BEE being used correctly, because they're investing in the lives of, was it's these black orphans. But it's kind of an interesting model, because they don't work on handouts. But what they do is companies invest in them, and they get shares, or they get shares in companies on the stock exchange. So they're actually generating money to reinvest. And whatever companies partner with them, get BEE points. So at the end of the day, it's a good model, because the ultimate beneficiaries are these young black orphans, and not individual opportunists who are enriching themselves at the expense of others. And I
Wow,
think that's a very good model.
that's a good model. That actually sounds like quite a good model. Thanks for sharing that. That's actually important. Okay. Shucks, I've run out. Do you mix with other race groups today?
I do. I
Well,
mean,
would you? I know you're married to Vicky, but do you believe in mixed marriages? Would you marry her? I mean, I don't say you will now because you are, but I mean, would it be in your nature to marry a person of another color?
probably not. I think it's a bit of a leap, and it's a leap that I didn't take. I think one particular couple of particular friends of mine, very good friends, and a white guy and a Indian lady, and I'm good friends with both of them. I don't have a problem with it. I can't say I've ever considered it myself, though, but I don't have an issue with it.
Thank you. Do you think whites are angry today? Do you think whites have accepted this new change fully? Or are they just playing lip service to it? Are they just saying that what everybody, have they accepted this new dispensation with the people of other race groups getting their jobs? And are they angry about it still?
I wouldn't say angry about
Maybe
it.
angry is
I
a
think
strong word.
we've accepted the situation, and I think what keeps us going as South Africans probably is sense of humour, and sometimes things aren't quite what they should be, but I think we just accept a lot.
No, thank you, Tony. We're at the end of this interview. Thank you for your valuable insight. Don't end yet. Anything else on this period, on the second period, that you'd like to add? Any advice to the new South Africans out there, or the older ones like us? Anything that you want to add, just brief.
No, no, not really. I think probably my generation has been a lot easier. But I think for some of the older people, I think they haven't quite adapted, and it's a lot more difficult for them. That's all I can say.
Thank you, Tony. The interview, this observe what is. Thank you, Tony. Look forward to the interviews, further interviews and come on. Thank you.
Thank you, Sean.